in the distortion is what ma, whatever the signals we are using, the signals will be changes its shape or form. Okay na, the whatever the signals, we don't have only one shape, we have different shapes. So every shape has its own different frequencies. So each signal component has its own propagation speed. So one of the signals has its own propagation speed when it reaches through the medium. So whenever that at the final destination, whatever the data is receiving, that is become delay and its arrival time will be delay as the given period of time. In other words, the signal components at the receiver have phase different what they had at the sender. The shape of the composite signal is therefore not the same. So distortion is not ma, one side we are in the same attenuation, we are also seeing in the distortion also. So sender send what some of the data to the receiver side. So whatever the sender said, that is not same at the receiver side. Okay na, so the shape will be changes in different formats and every shape has its own frequency and propagation speed. So this is called the distortion ma. So this is the image. So ikkada meeku kanipichina image chusaru kada ma, distortion ante entante signal manaki signals anedi different ways lo shapes anedi maartta untai. So ikkada sender side chusaru kada ma, idi different first composite signal sent. Okay na, idu vachi phases anamata, manam pampichindi idi, manam composite signal send chesindi idi adu. Okay na, first manaki image kanipistundi ma, first sender lo first wave kanipistundi kada, aa wave vachi manam pampichindi. సో ఎప్పుడైతే పంపిస్తామో సిగ్నల్ వేరియేషన్స్ వల్ల మనకి ఈ ఫామ్స్ అనేది చేంజ్ అయిపోతుంది. సో చూడండి, ఫస్ట్ వచ్చి కొంచెం డిస్టెన్స్ తీసుకొని కొంచెం వేవ్ అనేది డిఫరెంట్గా ఉంది, మళ్ళీ క్లోజ్డ్గా ఉంది, మళ్ళీ సైన్ అనేది మళ్ళీ కాని మెర్జ్ అయిపోయినట్టుంది సిగ్నల్ అనేది. సో ఇది ఒక ఫార్మేట్ అనమాట, ఇలా ఉంటుంది మన ఫార్మేట్ అనేది. ఈ ప్రతి ఒక్క సైన్కి దాని యొక్క ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ అనేది వేరేగా ఉంటుంది అండ్ ప్రాపగేషన్ స్పీడ్ కూడా వేరేగా ఉంటుంది. సో ఎప్పుడైతే రిసీవర్కి రీచ్ అవుతుందో అక్కడ చూసుకుంటే రిసీవర్ సైడ్ కూడా మనకి రీచ్ అయ్యే ఫేజెస్ అనేది అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ఫేజ్ అనమాట. మనం పంపించిన ఫేజ్ తీసుకుంటే కాంపోనెంట్స్ ఇన్ ఫేజ్ చూసుకున్న కాంపోనెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ఫేజ్ చూసుకుంటే డిఫరెన్స్ చూడండి ఎంత డిఫరెన్స్ ఉందో. సో డిఫరెన్స్ అనేది జరుగుతుంది. సో మనకి రిసీవర్ సైడ్కి వచ్చేసరికి మన డిఫరెన్స్ మన సైన్ అనేది ఇలా ఉంటుంది. ఓకేనా, సో మనకి వేరియేషన్ కనిపిస్తుంది కన్నా అట్ సెండర్ అట్ రిసీవర్. సో రెండింటికి చూసుకుంటే డిఫరెన్స్ చూసుకోండి, కాంపోజిట్ సిగ్నల్ అస్ సెంట్, కాంపోనెంట్ సిగ్నల్ రిసీవ్డ్, ఆ టూ సైన్స్ చూసుకుంటే మనకి డిఫరెన్స్ తెలుస్తుంది. దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫార్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ ది సిగ్నల్స్. ఓకేనా, సో నెక్స్ట్ కమింగ్ టు ద నాయిస్. వాట్ ఈస్ మీన్ బై నాయిస్? సో నాయిస్ ఈస్ ద అనదర్ కాజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంపైర్మెంట్లో ఇది ఈస్ ద అనదర్ పార్ట్. ఓకేనా, సో ఇన్ దిస్ నాయిస్ వీ హ్యావింగ్ సెవరల్ టైప్స్ సచ్ యాజ్ థర్మల్ నాయిస్, ఇండ్యూస్డ్ నాయిస్, క్రాస్ టాక్ నాయిస్ అండ్ ఇంపల్స్ నాయిస్. సో ఓకేనా, దీస్ ఆర్ ద ఫోర్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ నాయిసెస్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్. కమింగ్ టు ద ఫస్ట్ వన్ మా, ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ అ థర్మల్ నాయిస్. సో ఇన్ ద థర్మల్ నాయిస్ మీన్స్ ద ర్యాండమ్ మోషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్, ద ర్యాండమ్ థర్మల్ మోషన్. సో ఇఫ్ యు సీ దట్ హియర్, సో ఇన్ ద నాయిస్ సో ద నాయిస్ ఇస్ సచ్ అస్ థర్మల్ నాయిస్, ఇండ్యూస్డ్ నాయిస్ అండ్ క్రాస్ టాక్ నాయిస్ అండ్ ఇంపల్స్ నాయిస్ మే కరప్ట్ ద సిగ్నల్స్. దీస్ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్ నాయిసెస్ విల్ బి కరప్ట్ ద సిగ్నల్. సో ద థర్మల్ నాయిస్ ఈస్ ద ర్యాండమ్ మోషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఇన్ ఎ వైర్. ద థర్మల్ నాయిస్ ఈస్ ద ర్యాండమ్ మోషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఇన్ ఎ వైర్ విచ్ క్రియేట్స్ అన్ ఎక్స్ట్రా నాయిస్ నాట్ ఒరిజినలీ సెండ్ బై ద ట్రాన్స్మిటర్. So what are the transmitter, transmitter is sending the signal, that signal is transmitted through the receiver. Due to the random motion of electrons in a wire, the extra signals will be occurred. So at the transmitter, so that is called the thermal noise. What is mean by thermal noise ma? Due to the random motion of electrons in a wire, extra signals will be created. It is not originally sent by the transmitter, that is called the thermal noise. Next coming to the second one, induced noise. Induced noise comes from source such as motors and appliances. So these devices acts as a sending antenna and the transmission medium acts as a receiving antenna. So this is called the induced noise. Next, the third one, crosstalk ma. What is meant by crosstalk? Crosstalk is the effect of one wire to another. So, oka wire anedi crosstalk ante enti, in the point only we can understand that the meaning of the crosstalk. So, one of the wire will be affects the another wire. So, if one wire will be affected, another wire will be also affected. That is called the crosstalk. Okay, na? One wire acts as a sending antenna and another wire acts as a receiving antenna. Okay, na? Now coming to the impulse noise. Impulse noise is the speak. Impulse noise, Krishna Reddy. Krishna. Ma, I'm getting voice, ma. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Ma, voice is good. Please, ma, listen. So coming to the impulse noise, what is mean by impulse noise? Impulse noise is a speaker. Speak, S-P-I-K-E, speaker. Okay, that comes from
మ్యామ్ ఏం వినిపించట్లేదు మ్యామ్ మీ వాయిస్
మా నా వాయిస్ వినిపిస్తుందా
yes ma'am
సో ఇందక నుంచి ఏం చేస్తున్నారు నా వాయిస్ వినిపించట్లేదు చెప్పాలి కదా హలో మా ఆర్ యు హియర్ మై వాయిస్
yes ma'am
ఇందక నుంచి వాయిస్ వినిపించకపోతే చెప్పాలి కదా Okay, ma, listen. So next to coming to the signal to noise ratio. So in this signal to noise ratio, we have to find the theoretical bit rate limit. In this signal to noise ratio, we are going to find the theoretical bit rate limit. We need to know the ratio of the signal power to the noise power. We know the ratio of the signal power to the noise power. It is called signal to ratio. Signal to noise ratio is defined as SNR is equal to average signal power by average noise power. Average signal power by average noise power. This is the formula. So signal to noise ratio we are going to discussing now. So in the signal to noise ratio, we are going to find the theoretical bit rate limit in order to know the ratio of signal power to the noise power. సిగ్నల్ పవర్ యొక్క నాయిస్ పవర్ యొక్క రేషియోను కనుక్కోవడానికి మనం ఏం ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేస్తున్నాము థిరియాటికల్ బిట్ రేట్ అనేది ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేస్తాం దాని యొక్క ఫార్ములా ఏంటి ఎస్ఎన్ఆర్ షార్ట్కట్లో ఎస్ఎన్ఆర్ అని నోట్ చేస్తామా సిగ్నల్ టు నాయిస్కి ఎస్ఎన్ఆర్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు యావరేజ్ సిగ్నల్ పవర్ బై యావరేజ్ నాయిస్ పవర్ సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఫార్ములా ఆఫ్ ది ఎస్ఎన్ఆర్ సో నెక్స్ట్ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ దిస్ ఎస్ఎన్ఆర్ ఇన్ ద డెసిబెల్స్ ఓకేనా So SNR is actually the ratio of what is wanted signal and what is the wanted noise. So SNR is actually what we are using the signal or noise. The high SNR means the signal is less corrupted. If SNR అనేది హై గా ఉంటే మనం సిగ్నల్ అనేది తక్కువగా కరప్ట్ అయినట్టు అండ్ నాయిస్ అనేది ఎక్కువగా if SNR means the signal is less corrupted by noise. If you use the high SNR, high SNR means the signal is less corrupted by noise. A low SNR means the signal is more corrupted by noise. So you are seeing the difference, ma? Difference enti SNR anedi ekkuga unte సిగ్నల్ అనేది లెస్ కరప్ట్ అయినట్టు నాయిస్ అనేది ఎక్కువగా కరప్ట్ అయినట్టు అదే ఎస్ఎన్ఆర్ అనేది లోగా ఉంటే సిగ్నల్ అనేది మోర్ కరప్ట్ అయినట్టు నాయిస్ అనేది తక్కువగా కరప్ట్ అయినట్టు. ఓకేనా? సో ఆ కరప్టెడ్ మీన్స్ వాట్ మా ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఆర్ కరప్టెడ్ మీన్స్ సమ్ ఇంటరప్షన్స్ విల్ బి అకర్డ్ బిట్వీన్ ద కమ్యూనికేషన్ సో బిట్వీన్ దట్. సో ఓకేనా, దిస్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ద ఎస్ఎన్ఆర్. సో ద ఎస్ఎన్ఆర్ ఈస్ ద రేషియో ఆఫ్ టూ పవర్స్. ఎస్ఎన్ఆర్ ఈస్ ద రేషియో ఆఫ్ టూ పవర్స్. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ డిస్క్రైబ్డ్ బై ఇన్ ద డెసిబల్ యూనిట్స్. Decibel units, okay. SNR dB defined as SNR dB is equal to 10 log 10 SNR.
So this is the
formula of the decibel SNR. SNR means a short. This is the shortcut. Ma, what is the full form? SNR means signal to noise ratio. So it is measured in the decibels. So okay, na, what is the formula of SNR decibels? Is equal to 10 log base 10 SNR. So this is the formula of this SNR decibels. Now we are going to discuss about the data rate limits. Next coming to data rate limits. Okay, so these are the examples, ma. So I have taken a small program here. So this is the program. The power of the signal is 10 millivolts and the power of the noise is 1 microvolts. These values are substituted in the SNR and SNR decibels. So the value will be 10,040. So okay, na? So this like we are substituting the value. And this is at a zero. The if we get zero value, that will be in the noiseless channel. It will be infinity. Okay, na? Now coming to the these are the difference two cases of the SNR. When I told that when the we have high SNR, the signal will be less and less corrupted than the noise. If the low SNR, signal is more corrupted than the noise. So this is the first one, large SNR. Here signal is less corrupted than the noise. Signal anedi less corrupted anamata. So andukani dani oka signal anedi chana efficient ga exclusive ga undi. Okay, na? So this is the signal of the large SNR. Whenever the signal noise is corrupted more than the signal, this is the image of the noise. So if you combine both of these, the signal plus noise, this is the variations of the signal and noise. So individually we talk about the signal and noise, the images will be this like. If you combine that signal and noise, the image will be like that, signal plus noise. So this is the large SNR. If you talk about the small SNR means signal will be less more corrupted and noise will be less corrupted. So if you see the difference, signal has the shape is very less and noise is some more compared to the upper large SNR. If you see the down of the image, small SNR, there is so much difference. So this signal and SNR will is combined. The signal plus SNR, this is the shape of the signal or sign of the signal. Okay, na? So this is the examples of the SNR, high SNR and low SNR.
Next
coming to the data rate, ma. One second. Next topic is data rate limit. Next topic is data limit, data rate limits. Okay, so data rate limits is nothing but the data rate depends on three factors. The data rate depends on three factors. So see the presentation, ma. So second. So data rate limit depends on three factors. The bandwidth. So Seema, one second. So data rate limit. The data rate depends on three factors. That is the bandwidth available, the level of the signal we use, the quality of the channel, the level of noise. So these are the three factors we are having in the data rate. So what is meant by data rate? A very important characteristics, a very important consideration in data communication is how fast we can send data. So how fast we can send data in bits per second over a channel. So the data rate depends on So what is the three points, the three factors in the data rate, ma? So that is bandwidth available. So whenever we are sending the, we are using the network, we have to maintain the bandwidth. The bandwidth is nothing but the level of the speed, performance of the speed of the network. That is called the bandwidth. We have to maintain the first one, bandwidth available. We need to have the bandwidth available. Next, the level of the signals. So we have also observed the level of the signals, how we are maintaining between the sender and the receiver. So this is the second important point we have to use in the data rate limit, ma. So quality of the channel. Whenever we are sending the data from one node to the another node, we have to check the channel. Channel also very important. We have to check the quality of the channel at the level of noise. I told that in the noise we have different four types of noises. So we have to observe that noises. If we have a noises, that will be solved by using the solutions about that noise. Okay, na? So these are the three factors available in that. Why we are using these three factors means faster to send the data. The communication will be occurred very fast between the sender data to the sender node to the receiver node. That can be measured in the bits per second over the channel. Okay, na? These are the important factors we have to follow in the data rate limit. So the two theoretical formulas were developed to calculate the data rate. One by Nyquist, N-Y-Q-U-I-S-T. It is the name of the person. Okay, na? So one of the theoretical formula was calculated by data rate, one by Nyquist for the noiseless channel and another by Shannon for a noisy channel. So two persons discussed about this noisy and noiseless channel. Noiseless channel will be discussed by the Nyquist, and Shannon was determined by the noisy channel. So noiseless channel, coming to the noiseless channel. Okay, na? Noiseless channel determined by the Nyquist bit rate. So for the noiseless channel, the Nyquist bit rate formula defines the theoretical maximum bit rate. So the Nyquist, the noiseless channel, noisy channel. Noiseless ante enti, noise lekunda channel anedi maintain cheyadam. So idochi na Nyquist ane oka person anedi determine chesaru. So andukani Nyquist bit rate formula defines in a theoretical maximum bit rate. So bit rate is equal to 2 into bandwidth into log base 2 capital L. So in this formula, bandwidth is the bandwidth of the channel. In this formula we are using bandwidth. This is nothing but bandwidth of the channel. L is the number of signal levels. L is the number of signal levels. Whatever the you are using, L is the number of signal levels used to represent the data. And the bit rate is nothing but bit rate in bits per second. Bit rate is nothing but bits per second. We are calculating the value in a bit rates per second. So this is the means of noise channel, noiseless channel by Quist bit rate. Okay, in this formula, according to this formula, we might think that given a specific bandwidth, we have any bit rate we want by increasing the number of signal levels. So the idea is theoretically correct. Practically, there is a limit. When we increase the number of signal levels, we impose a burden on receiver. If the number of levels in the signal is just 2, the receiver can easily distinguish between a 0 and a 1. If the signal is 64, the receiver must be very sophisticated to distinguish between 64 different levels. In other words, increasing the levels of the signal reduces the reliability of the systems. So this is called the noiseless channel determined by the Nyquist bit rate. So next to coming to the noisy channel. What is mean by noisy channel? Coming to the noisy channel. So in this noisy channel, in reality, we can't have a noiseless channel. In reality, we don't have any noiseless channel. The channel is always noisy. The channel is always noisy. In 1944, Claude Shannon introduced a formula called Shannon capacity to determine the theoretical highest data rate for a noisy channel. You are using the Shannon capacity formula. Shannon capacity is nothing but capacity is equal to bandwidth into log base 2 into 1 plus SNR. Okay, so this is the formula. C is the capacity is equal to bandwidth into log base 2 plus base 2 into 1 plus SNR. SNR means signal to ratio, noise ratio, signal to noise ratio. In this formula, the bandwidth is the bandwidth of the channel. In this formula, whatever we are using the bandwidth, it is called bandwidth of the channel, and SNR is the signal to noise ratio, and the capacity is the capacity of the channel in bits per second. Note that the Shannon formula, there is no indication of the signal level. What is mean? No matter how many levels we have. So this is called the noisy channel, determined by the Shannon capacity. Okay, so these are the different things we have learned in the noisy channel. Okay, now noisy channel. Next, we are having the performance. Next, coming to the performance. So what is meant by performance? One important issue is in networking. We are having different points of the performance. Performance is nothing but we are going to measuring the network performance. Speed of the network performance, how the network is good or not. That is declared in the different ways. That is called the performance. So that is, now in this we are having bandwidth. Okay, bandwidth in hertz, bandwidth in bits per second. So coming to the bandwidth, what is mean by bandwidth? Bandwidth is nothing but we are having the one characteristics that to measure the network performance. Network performance ni measure cheyadaniki we are using one characteristic. That characteristic is called bandwidth. So in terms we can use these two different contest. So this bandwidth can be determined in the two different measuring values. One is bandwidth in hertz and bandwidth in bits per second. Coming to the bandwidth in hertz, what is mean by bandwidth in hertz? So hertz, we are going to measure the range of the frequency. Bandwidth hertz is to measure the range of the frequency contained in a composite signals or range of frequencies a channel can passes. So what is mean by composite signals? The signals can be divided into multiple parts, okay, na? Or the range of the frequencies of a channel can passes. For example, we can say that bandwidth of a subscriber telephone line is 4 kilohertz. So this is the bandwidth in hertz. So second one, what we are going to measure the network performance, that is bandwidth in bits per second. So the term bandwidth can also refer to the number of bits per second that a channel, a link, or even a network can transmit. For example, one can say that bandwidth for a fast Ethernet network, that is nothing but our links in this network. So it is a maximum of 100 megabits per second. This means the network can send 100 megabits per second from one node to the another node. So this is the network. We are going to measure the network performance through bandwidth. So in the bandwidth, these are two that can be measured in two contests. That is bandwidth in hertz, bandwidth in bits per second. So these are the bandwidth. Next, coming to the relationship. So what is mean by relationship? So there is an explicit relationship between the bandwidth and in hertz and bandwidth in bits per second. So in order to increase the bandwidth in hertz means the increase of bandwidth in bits per second, the relationship depends on whether we can baseband transmission or transmission with modulation. So this is called the relationship between the bandwidth hertz in and bandwidth in bits per second. So next, coming to the throughput. What is mean by throughput? After bandwidth, we are talking about the throughput. Throughput is the measure of low how fast we can actually send the data through a network. So network lo mana data anadi enta fast anadi calculate chestundi throughput anadi. The throughput is a measure of how fast we can actually send the data through a network. So at first glance, bandwidth in bits per second and throughput seems the same. So they are different. So a link may have a bandwidth of b bits per second, but we can only send t bits per second through this link with a t always less than b. In other words, the bandwidth is a potential measurement of a link. The throughput is actual measurement of how fast the data can be sent from sender to receiver. For example, we may have a link with a bandwidth of 1 megabits per second, but the devices connected to the end of the link may be handle only 200 kilobits per second. This means that we cannot send more than 200 kilobits per second through this link. So this is called the throughput. So I'm having the small problem here. So a network with bandwidth having 10 megabits per second, and that can be passes only average 1200 frames per minute, with each frame carrying an average 1000 bits. So what is the throughput of this network? The solution is this throughput is equal to this is the throughput formula, 12,000 into 10,000 by 60. So the what is the solution of this throughput is through 2 megabits per second. So the we have to maintain the 200 kbps, okay, na, at the receiver side, sender to receiver. So this is the limit of the data sending from one node to the another node. So this is called throughput. So next, coming to the latency. What is mean by latency? So latency, or we can say it is a delay. Latency is also called a delay. So it defines how long it takes for an entire message to complete the arrival at the destination from at the time of first bit is sent out from the source. So delay means what? Between the sender and the receiver, whatever the data we are sending, that should be reach in a given period of time. If it is not reach at the given period of time, that will be delay. It will be the data will be delay between the transmission. So okay, na? So we can say that the latency is made of four components: propagation time, transmission time, queuing time, and processing delay. So these are the four components we having in the latency. So latency is equal to formula. This is the formula, ma. See. So this is the formula. Latency is equal to propagation time plus transmission time plus queuing time plus processing delay. So we having the propagation. What is mean by propagation time? Propagation time measures the time required. Propagation time is time measures the times required for bit to travel from source to the destination. Propagation time is what, ma? From source to destination, whatever the bit is traveling, that is that provided the time required by the user. Okay, na? The propagation time is calculated by dividing the distance by the propagation speed. So that is called the propagation time. So we are having the formula here. Propagation time is equal to distance by propagation speed. Okay, na? The propagation speed is a electromagnetic signal depends on the medium, on the frequency of the signal. So this is called the propagation time. Coming to the transmission time. What is mean by transmission time? In the data communication, we don't send just one bit. We send a message. Okay, na? The first bit may take a time equal to the propagation time to reach its destination. So the last bit also may take the same amount of time. So whatever the data we are sending from the source to the destination, the transmitter time, we are not sending the one bit. We are sending the message. So in the message, the first bit, whatever the time we are taken to reach the destination, that same time is taken by the last bit also. So that is called the transmission time. There is a time between first bit leaving the sender and the last bit arriving the receiver. So both are maintaining the same time. The first bit leaves earlier and arrives earlier. The last bit leaves later and arrives later. the time required for transmission of message depends on size of the message and the bandwidth of the channel. So transmission time means what, ma? 1 bit is between the sender and the receiver. We are sending the data. That's a data will be a message or any information. So not it has a just 1 bit. It is a message. So whatever the first bit, first value of that message will be take the time. That much same data also taken by the last letter of that message also. So okay, now that is there is no delay between the first letter to the last letter. Okay, now this is the transmission time. The message formula of the transmission time is called messages sizes by bandwidth. Message size by bandwidth. So this is called the transmission time. So next, coming to the queuing time, the third component in latency is the queuing time. The time needed to reach the time needed to each intermediate or end devices to hold the message before it can proceed. So the queuing time is not a fixed factor. The queuing time is not a fixed factor. It changes with load imposed on the network. When there is a heavy traffic on the network, if there is heavy traffic on the network, the queuing time increases. The intermediate devices such as routers, queues, are arrived messages and process them one by one. If there are many messages, if there is many messages, each message will have to wait. So this is the queuing time. So next, coming to bandwidth delay product. Okay, now in the queuing time we are having bandwidth and delay product. That is nothing but bandwidth and delay are two performance matrices of a link. What is very important in data communication is product of the two, the bandwidth delay product. Let us elaborate this issue using two hypothetical cases as examples. If you see the figure, okay, ma. So this is called the bandwidth delay product. Okay. Next, latency, ma. So last one. So this is the last one, jitter. So what is mean by jitter? If there is a variations in the signal, there is variation in the signal or the devices. So if you use the portable devices can like mobile, laptop. So this will be moved from one place to another place. If you send data from one place and received at the other place, the due to the signals or movement of the devices, the signals will be get some variations. So that is called the jitter. So we can roughly say that jitter is a problem if different packets of data encounter different delays and the application using the data at the receiver side, the time sensitive. It means the radio, audio, video, and any images. This type of information will be have more resolution. So that is why the data will be delayed sometimes due to the signal variations and device variations. So in this, we having sender and the receiver. The sender will be send the data from one location. After, because whatever the device he using, that is portable. So whenever the device moves from one place to the another place, the signal variations will be occurred. So due to that variations, some data will be lost and connections will be, signals will be break and collisions will be occurred due to the overloaded of traffic. These types of problems will be occurred between the sender to the receiver. So that is called the jitter problems. So these are the different things we are going to discuss in this topic, ma. So in the next class, we are going to discuss about the transmission media. Okay. Hello. Okay, ma. Hemant Kumar.
Come on.
Okay. Up to here, I think you understand.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, madam.
Okay, ma. So due to some issues, class will be late today. So can I stop here, ma? In the next class, I will be continue. Hello.
Ma'am.
Hello, are you able to hear my voice, ma?
Yes, madam.
Okay, ma. Can I continue the next class, ma?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma. I will take the attendance. One second. Okay, ma. Can you leave the class?
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, ma. Thank you. Bye.